Okay, so the last thing you want to do is get your knife, and you're going to have to do fine. Shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul. Seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek. We're so sorry, it's your
vision. Welcome, everybody, to a Halloween special of jse-theory-related Theory. And today's video has some very old news, but some of the things that I never got to talk about. But boy, do we get a few things that happened this year. Well, a few things. So, like I said in the intro, these are pretty much outdated, but, you know, I gotta come up with something for Halloween. So, let's end October with some spooks. So, Mayhem kind of started off with a bang when Jack uploaded a video with the title, "Welcome to My House, Please Stay Away, The Open House." And the video itself didn't involve anything sus until you scroll down to the comments of that same video. So what you're seeing right there is a comment from Jack himself. And oh boy, I haven't seen these in over a while. So allow me to explain, but it's kind of self-explanatory. This is a comment from Jack himself, and it says offer accepted in Zoggle text. Now looking back at it, it was highly sus of him just to leave a Zoggle-fied YouTube comment like that. And also, apparently the offer accepted thing was also a thing that happened in the open house game. So, I guess it kind of counts as a sus, but at the same time, not a sus thing. Although, it was pretty, like, out there in the comments. And this was on the first day of May. And I repeat, first day of May. But that was just the beginning of this new mayhem. On to the next video was the title, I Remembered a Stream. Now, the video itself didn't involve anything out of the ordinary weird, but it was a little sus because of the title and thumbnail. So, first of all, I'm getting some flashbacks to 2018 Mayhem, because a quote that sounds a little too familiar when I saw that title.
I remember what he did to me.
Now for the thumbnail, a silhouette standing, not in the hallway, surprisingly. That looks very familiar. Some of these videos are basically reminding me of the days of 2018 Mayhem, because that will never go away. And the next video uploaded was a SCP-related video. Now, I have not watched any of his videos in over a while, due to Overwatch and Valorant keeping me busy 24/7. There wasn't a lot of new things that happened during this year's mayhem, but on to the other things that I want to talk about, and that is this teaser clip right here. So this isn't JSE related, but I want to bring Mark into this because back in September, Mark uploaded a Minecraft video, and the video starts out as normal, Until about 15 or 16 seconds in, he decides to do this.
So...
So that little teaser had the community wondering what it was. Until I saw some theories about it on Tumblr. Let's go over some theories about this video. And before I do, I gotta say, some of these theories include audios and a video that will be brought up multiple times. So let's get to it.
I'm gonna go get some water.
Okay, hear me out. So in today's video, Marika gave us a little preview of a door zooming out with some very distinct noises of possibly a steam engine or a train. I had reason to believe that it was a train car of some kind. In Wilfred Madeleine Worf's stash, Wolf says the following to the detective.
Oh, the train. Oh, I remember the train. How long were we stuck in the snow for?
What? Followed by, oh, that probably hasn't happened yet. I think that this is a sequel to a heist with Markiplier. So, here's what I think about the scene with the door. I think that the door goes to the different passenger cars where the passengers are sitting. I think that this sequel will most likely be related to the murder on the Oriental Express, and it will take place in the winter, based on this scene from Wilfred Muddleberry Worstash.
Oh, the train. Oh, I remember the train. How long were we stuck in the snow for? Oh, you don't remember? Ah, it's okay. Probably hasn't happened yet. But some of your finest work, I have to say. A little spoiler alert for later to make it easier on you. We all did it.
So based on these scenes, Wilfred tells Abe about the train and what's in the teaser scene. A train door. Then Wilfred is telling Abe that that hasn't happened yet. But it's some of his best work and he's a detective. So maybe he would be investigating a murder. And then he says, a little spoiler alert for later, to make it easier on you, we all did it. So Wilfred is predicting the future, since he can alter reality, and telling Abe about something that's going to happen on a train. I think that there will be a murder on the train, and we will either be the ones investigating the crime scene, or Abe, the detective, will be on the train and investigate the scene. So maybe in the teaser trailer, us and Mark or Abe could be going from cart to cart, asking people questions about the murder victim or victims. I'm thinking maybe the title will be called A Mystery with Markiplier, or A Murder with Markiplier. Those are just my thoughts on the whole scene. So those were some of the theories that I've gathered from Tumblr. And I think that was the only thing that's happened in September. Well, maybe only thing. Because during that same month, on the day September 24th, just 2 days after my birthday, Jack was live on Twitch, basically kind of going over one of the ego videos, one of them being Chase and Say Goodbye. Now, I have not watched the stream myself, but maybe when I'm editing this, I'll add in some updates. And, speaking of updates, I actually kind of watched the part where, Sean watched, or rewatched Say Goodbye, and basically, just kind of cringed at the very few moments that happened in the video. But I don't think anything sus happened, except for the fact that, it was pretty weird because in that same stream, Sean also did a breakdown video of the Chase video, and I'll probably link that video in the description because I have seen someone repost it on YouTube. So, on to the next thing. Until a few days ago, and yeah, let me remind you, this happened a few days ago. Jack was live on Twitch, probably doing another Among Us or Phasmophobia stream, but I seen this picture float around on Instagram, so I want to share it here. So, the picture that I'm about to show was, I think this was kind of at the start of the stream. I don't know, I didn't really watch the stream myself because, you know, I'm really busy nowadays. But I've seen a picture go around I didn't see it go around on Tumblr, but I just seen that picture on Instagram, and apparently in that picture, from the context that I could gather from, it looks like there's like a secondary camera in the background. I don't really know what purpose that secondary camera is for, but I have some thoughts, and that was my phone just buzzing away. But I have a few thoughts. Well, maybe not really, but a couple of thoughts on what that second camera is for. So, number one, it could be a spooky bit for maybe a spooky video. Since we are nearing the end of October, in which sadly I actually did not get to do the things that I wanted to do for this month because, well, mostly for the Overwatch Halloween event that was happening and Valorant having a new agent, in which I'm still trying to work on. But yeah. And number two, maybe a comeback of a certain ego. Because if you guys remember last year we had a lot of comebacks. Last year we had Chase, we had Schneep, and surprisingly we had JJ. JJ had a comeback. Poor JJ got possessed for the second time. So if JJ does kind of make a comeback, like, homeboy better not get possessed for the third time, because I can't take any more of my boys being possessed by Auntie, I swear to fuck, if you're out there. And so that was pretty much what's happened back in September. So now we're gonna go over my favorite segment of the video, and that is random theories. Why can't you fucking hear me? All of these theory posts come from one Tumblr account, and that is the Tumblr account Mirror Tales on Tumblr. So I'm basically gonna be reading all of the theory posts that they have up until like more recently. So we're gonna start from the very beginning. I'll probably mark a timestamp on this video, so let's read some theories. So this one is called Time Loop. This week's theory came from our favorite magician and a half hour of back and forth banter. The mysterious magician. We know next to nothing about our favorite mask wearing magician, Marvin the Magnificent. We do know he knows at least some form of magic. One other character has been shown to have magic, our topic of last week and our favorite glitch ante. This means there could be a connection between the two. What do I mean by that? I'm not sure myself, but there isn't much more to go off of. So until we see them again, we can't say much more about that theory. What we do know is ante might have a plan up his sleeve and such, would probably do something to prevent the others from interfering. This leads us to today's theory. A time loop. Perhaps Ante trapped our other fellow egos in a time loop. Marvin, obviously knowing magic, tries to escape so he can warn Jack and protect him from the glitch. Said glitch did his homework and created a loop where Marvin's progress in magic is hindered. He can't learn and improve his magic as fast as in the real world, rendering him useless for the better part of a few years. This would explain his sudden disappearance and lack of interaction with both us and the others. He's trapped without a way of communication. This brings us to an interesting part of the theory, the origins of the latest ego, James and Jackson. As time curls by and Marvin tries various spells in an effort to escape, one might have backfired, resulting in a character from the past resulting in a character from the past existing in an alternate loop. The spell has a nasty side effect on a new character, leaving him mute. Perhaps he lost the thing he cared about the most, a voice. Now, this would have an effect on Marvin too. He realizes what he's done, and perhaps he tries to find a way to communicate with the other egos. He tries to find a spell to escape and warn the others. Perhaps he was warning us all along. In any effort to tell us something we don't know. He likely knows Auntie's plan, or at least what he plans to do with Jack, but he's still trapped despite his efforts. Now, as we reach the Chase part of the timeline, there is one big problem. Chase teleports without actually doing it himself. He's too confused and drunk to know what's going on. If the theories of Marvin casting teleportation spells are correct, perhaps he tested it on Chase to free him out of his time loop. Maybe Chase is in the real world with Jack and Auntie. The reason why I believe this is because Marvin might be planning some way to get rid of Auntie once and for all. If the spell was successful, he could free himself and the others. Obviously, it will take a lot out of him, so he needs to rest up first. But his stunt didn't go unnoticed. Teleporting Chase sparked Schneep's interest. That's why he was trying to figure out the wormhole. This brings us to the last important piece to tie everything to the present. Schneep finds the wormhole, and maybe he finds out about the time loops. Maybe he's thinking of a way to get Marvin out. This would explain why he's cautious, and also why he seems to know the most out of the egos, save for Marvin. So this was the theory that was mentioned in the last theory post. So this one is called Auntie. I know what you're thinking. This character, or ego if you prefer, has been the subject of debate since the Finance of Freddy's sister location fiasco, but hear me out. Somebody and I have been thinking about things, and one thing stood out to us about our favorite glitchy demon. The motive of chaos. What exactly do I mean by this? Let me explain. We all know from all of Auntie's appearances that his mood changes drastically in an instant, but I believe that there's more to it than that. Someone pointed out that he's calm and controlling, while I pointed out he's aggressive and stubborn. What does this mean? He's usually controlling and calm. That's what we see when he glitches on screen for a few seconds. If he isn't angered or provoked, he doesn't have much reason to be aggressive. Well, he doesn't have any other reason. When he does take over and speak to us, he's usually aggressive and stubborn. Something usually leads to his appearance. In other words, something provoked him into attacking. This leads me to believe there are certain things that trigger him. What does this have to do with his motives? Well, if something triggers Auntie to lose his cool and attack, it means it's an important thing. Say for example, a fisherman wants to catch a big fish for dinner, but his fishing equipment was stolen. His motive would be to find the equipment because it's important to fulfill that goal. If we use this logic, we can figure out what Auntie's motives are. Number one, in his first appearance, he's somewhat calm and more malicious than aggressive. He blames us for Jack's death before leaving us. We can assume Dr. Schneep saves Jack from his playthrough of Bio-Inc. Number two, during the intro for PAX, Auntie appears for a second time. This time around, he's more aggressive and annoyed because of Jack. Jack was revived after he killed him and probably pushed him away in fear. He was quickly replaced and ignored. Jack's actions to protect only added fuel to an already burning fire. Number three, finally, during Kill Jack's Up the Guy, he was very aggressive and controlling. Again, there was a reason for his behavior. He doesn't enjoy the extreme measures required to get what he wants, and he's obviously jealous of the attention the other egos get. This is all tied together by the one reason why he even did the effort and said goodbye. He craves attention from us, possibly because it makes him stronger. If Auntie is the opposite of Jack, then he would crave attention where Jack shies away from it. His craving for attention and jealousy could be the reason why he's interfering with the other egos, possibly to stop them from interfering and stealing his spotlight. Auntie's motive is different from normal ones because his motive doesn't affect his decisions or actions. He is a character of chaos and unpredictability. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong. where Jack prefers, I mean, where Jack prefers order, and his nature is what makes him unique. Since he doesn't rely on his motive to cause chaos, that's why he doesn't always appear and kill Jack, because he doesn't have to. He is also a master of manipulation, which also changes the game a little. In short, Anti is a chaotic, evil character who manipulates for personal gain. His motive is to get attention, but he doesn't always follow his motives. As long as he's causing chaos, he's happy. This one is called the Alter Ego, and no, it's not the one from Danganronpa. The conversation. I'm not completely sure when exactly Jack posted the conversation with the egos on Tumblr, but it might hold some clues as to the ego's involvement, which I'm probably guessing the conversation is probably the one on Discord back like a year ago. From their conversation, we can assume that Schneep and Marvin knew the most, or perhaps got important intel. Chase might know something important, but his focus is on Jack. Like I said in a previous post, Chase is afraid of losing what's left of his family. This means Chase is focused on getting Jack back. Perhaps he knows what's going to happen to Jack if they can't save him. His dialogue from Dark Silence might give this away. Jimison doesn't want to get involved with anything. This could be because he was possessed by the Anti twice, and because of his fear and manipulation, it's difficult to tell what exactly his motives are. But he seems to be the least involved and most terrified. Now with that out of the way, we can focus on the other point we left out, Jack's knowledge. Him being the creator and leader would mean he knows the most, right? Unfortunately, no. Anti could possibly be sharing bodies with Jack. We can assume this from his efforts to appear. Him never appearing with Jack simultaneously, and some of the dialogue from both of them. Does this mean Anti's powerless when Jack's in control? Not exactly. Jack doesn't know much about what happened to the others. It is possible that Anti can observe what happens when Jack is in control, as well as blocking Jack from seeing what's going on. If this is true, then the others might be quiet to protect Jack. Perhaps they believe the less he knows, the safer he is. Whatever the case, we'll find out what's going on soon enough. Keeping us in the dark might be part of their plan to keep Jack safe. If we don't know what's going on, then we can't tell Jack. This next theory from the same account is called Chase. First of all, it's worth mentioning that Dark Silence was created before Chase. That means we'll look at it first. The thing that stood out to us was how quickly Chase's emotions changed. While he explored, he was cautious and confused. After he saw Anti, it quickly changed to fear and worry. It could mean that they've seen each other before. Or it could be Anti affecting him. His presence could affect how Chase reacts and what he says, for example. This could refer to his kids, like many people believe, or maybe the other ego is still trapped in their own time loops. Whatever the case is, we see him alone in Chase.
What do you want from me?
Anti did something to upset Chase, so he asked what the glitch wants. Again, many believe it's his kids. But it could be more than that. Who says he stopped there? Maybe Anti has something to do with Stacy divorcing him. Maybe he gave him his depression. Now let's look at the main part of the story. Chase. We know his kids are missing from his emotions throughout the video. It's possible Anti killed them to make sure his puppet didn't get any ideas or just to break him and shut him up. It wouldn't be too difficult, considering the egos all look similar. The kids believed it was their dad, and obviously listened to him, so he could have created an accident. We believe it would much rather be the former, since it would be way more fun. Secondly, we see he's evicted from his house. Things are going downhill for him. Adding to his already bad depression, he's been living in his car for at least a few days. Thirdly, we see a figure in his car for a split second. Now, there's been some debate on whether it's Auntie or Marvin, but we believe we figure it out. The figure has the same expression. The figure has the same expression Auntie shows in the cubicle in dark silence. If our previous theories are correct, then Marvin wouldn't be adept enough to use that much magic. We've never seen him perform something that complex, especially in rapid succession. Auntie would know how to cast that type of magic, and would also be powerful enough to pull it off. Right before he disappears, Chase pulls out a bottle of whiskey. This could mean Auntie's tempting him to drink alcohol. Maybe he promised his kids that he stopped drinking, but it isn't that easy with the glitch. Also, while we're talking about whiskey, an important detail many people overlook might prove our time loop theory. Ever notice that Chase is drinking before he's teleported, but afterwards, the bottle just disappears? If it's a time loop, Auntie's temptations and hold over Chase will break if it's broken. Thus, he wouldn't have whiskey anymore. Marvin wasn't there to help Chase after the teleportation. Before anyone starts an argument, we know technically no one helped him, but it's still worth noting. It's possible the spell didn't work perfectly and he ended up feeling too exhausted to help. Or perhaps Auntie messed with the spell hoping to get rid of Chase. Once and for all, through this. The figure's body language was eerie and negative. He gives off bad vibes. Something we know the magician doesn't have. Perhaps the reason for his visit was to make sure Marvin hasn't interfered, and that things are going according to plan. If it was truly Marvin, he would have told Chase. What does this all mean? We believe there's too many clues pointing towards Auntie being in the car. It would make the most sense when you consider the characters and storyline. Now, if it is Auntie, then we could go one step further and analyze his expression. From what we could tell, it's a dark, knowing expression. Does he know what Marvin's doing? Is he doing whatever it takes to keep Chase under his control? So this is the last one. I'm not sure if there's any more related theories on this. But I was looking through the account, and they've also done some Undertale-related theories. And there's also, like, anti-theory discussion posts that I've seen, but I don't think I'll read them anytime soon. So this is the last one, well, for now, on this account, and this is the one called Puppet Strings. So the main question this week is something I've been wondering ever since the Chase theory a couple weeks ago. That, of course, led down a rabbit hole to another theory. This week's question, why didn't Auntie do anything after kill Jacksepticeye? Sure, you could argue that Jack's in a coma, but I doubt that's the reason. If Jack was in a coma, wouldn't that entice Auntie to strike while he's out? Instead, he switched his focus to Chase and the others. Why? I am not sure yet. However, lead me to this week's theory. Jack stated in a vlog after one of Auntie's appearances that Auntie isn't a fully written character yet. This explains why some parts don't make sense or suddenly change. He isn't completely written out, which means he doesn't have a specific way to do things. The community is responsible for creating those parts. The missing parts means we'll have to focus on something else to figure out exactly what makes him tick. Thus, we narrowed our search to what he says.
Stalking me with your glitch, bitch.
This is Auntie's way of telling us that he doesn't like how the community mocks him and makes fun of him, especially since we created him.
It's all your fault.
We created him, we made him the way he is, so it's our fault Jack died.
You found someone new! Threw me aside! Someone to replace me!
Jack replaced him with the other egos. He stole Auntie's attention and screen time and hid him from us. The reason for this is unknown, but we've narrowed down a few possible reasons. Number 1. Jack might be hiding something from us. Is there something we should know that Jack is intentionally hiding? Why is it upsetting Auntie? Does it have to do with Auntie's backstory or something we haven't figured out yet? It wasn't meant to stretch past Halloween. In one of Jack's vlogs, he explained that Auntie was only meant to be a little Halloween fun. He never intended to take it further than say goodbye.
I'm not going anywhere!
Auntie isn't going to allow Jack to push him away and hide him again to be forgotten and replaced. This line was broken up and mixed together. Is Auntie trying to tell us something? Again, Jack might be hiding something.
Then why don't you save him?
The community has the power to change everything. Yet we've done nothing to stop Auntie. Perhaps he finds it intriguing how the puppet masters don't pull strings and leaves him in control instead of saving the one they like. So those were all the theories from that account. If they do post more, I will probably add it either in a mini theory video or perhaps in another theory video. But those were all the theories from the account. Oh my! Oh my god! Whew! I haven't been out of the closet since... how many months? Basically to start a quarantine? Oh my god! There's been some news happening. Well, I would say today. Alright, Oh. Jack is being sus. Emergency meeting! We gotta call an emergency meeting. Cue the, emergency meeting sound.
Alright, so yesterday and today, Jack has been very sus these past 2 days, and I can't believe this boy just does this, and sets his community on fire. But let me explain about all of this. So on October 27th, Jack posted a very sus photo on his Discord server, and it was in the Panic Room chat room, and it was pinned. But let me show the photo. So this picture is very sus, and somehow like the chase photos were last year, it gives off that same vibe. But I checked Tumblr when this happened, and boy, haven't seen the community freak out in over a while, so let's take a look at the theories about this picture. So today, Jack posted this picture on his Discord, and I'm 100% convinced the next ego to make an appearance is Marvin. First, we see the contents of the table, a white candle, a glass/crystal sphere, and a leather-bound book. A strange collection of items for the average person. But not if you're practicing magic. I myself am a practicer of witchcraft, and when I zoomed into the picture and brightened it, I thought I recognized one of the symbols. And I was correct, they're runes. Runes were predominantly used by Vikings, but are now a common tool for the modern day witch, since they can be drawn and explained away as some kind of doodle or original design. Here's the list of runes commonly used in binding. In binding, one uses magic to keep an item away from harm and to keep it in your possession, as well as protecting it from hexes and bad charms. The first line, Othala, Ingus, and Raidus. Second line, Ingus, a sideways Izer, and a second Ingus. From what we can interpret, this is a binding spell put on the cover. The person who owns this book has binded it, so that it is known that it is this. It grows as they do work in it, and no one may see or touch this. This is common practice in witchcraft, especially when crafting a grimoire. Binding it to yourself keeps it from falling into the hands of malevolent people and keeps your notes safe. Second, we see the sphere. Judging from the possible grimoire, we can assume that this is a crystal ball, which is commonly used for divination. Third is the candle. Candles are commonly used in witchcraft, since they act as a sort of catch-all replacement for any other colored candle. If a spell calls for a specific color of candle, white can almost always be substituted. Even the cloth is significant. A traditional workspace in the craft has a cloth covering the table. Why? I don't really know. It's a traditional thing, I believe. Black, protection, rebelling slash absorbing or banishing negative energy or hexes. Putting an end to an unhealthy situation. Protection can be under anything at this point. It can be mental for Marvin, Chase, or Jack, whether that be dealing with depression, mourning for Chase, since he was mourning over his mother in Chase, anxiety. Personally, I think that goes more into crystals. Negative energy can possibly fall underneath anti, or if we want to go near the dark applier and antiseptic eye root, where could have possibly put a curse on either Henrik or Jack, who then brought it home, explaining the banishing and possibly either anti's appearance. If we go on the demon route, or the curse could have been thrown on Chase. Negative energy and mental negative energy do not mix well together, especially if it involves a person having conflict with themselves and their decisions. Rebelling. Anti has only called the JSE egos puppets once, and that was and killed JSE, so that can also be the case. Or again, we can go on another route and think of the possibility of Marvin being evil or siding with Anti, whether he's being controlled slash manipulated or wants to on his own. Unhealthy situations can fall under Chase and his high increase in drinking, along with depression. These were just little thoughts and bits of pieces I had while doing some research on sigils, which that then went to candles. Marvin. Finally, after 4 years, Marvin. This image was posted by Sean in the Ego Panic Room in the official JSE Discord. What we see: a magic 8-ball, crystal ball, candle, a spell book that I think might have runes or something on the front, but they're at an angle which I can't really see what they are. Not only that, in October last year, Chase's return was teased the same way. We are getting a Marvin short, but I'm confused. Sean said that Jackie would be the next ego we'd see. Obviously he can change his mind and he might have, but as a Jackie stan, I've been clinging to that tidbit of information all year, so I'm surprised we're being teased with Marvin. But god am I thrilled to finally have some new fire to burn in nonetheless. I also have a couple really random, but probably inaccurate thoughts about this. Halloween this year is a full blue moon. That's big witchy stuff right there. The blue moon on October 31st 2020 will be the first full moon on Halloween in 76 years. Kinda fitting for Marvin, if he's appearing in 3 days, isn't it? The thumbnail from Sean's month break return looked very Marvin-y to some of the community. Personally, I didn't think it was anything, at least from what I remember. I'm still very skeptical. But that title and thumbnail are pretty fitting for this nonetheless, ain't it? We did get Marvin's card suits presented to us in Jameson's return video last year too. So let's all enjoy this fire together like the good old times. Happy Halloween, y'all. So let me explain more about the second picture that Jack posted. I did a bit of research because on Tumblr, some people were mentioning Philosopher's Stone and the Black Crystal Ball. And here is what I found. Black Crystal Ball is symbolic of protection and wards off negative energy. That sounds familiar. And there is also mentions of alchemy and life elixir. Now let me do some research. So Marvin is studying philosophy and astrology, which is something that just screams Marvin. And I also did a little bit of research of life elixir. Alchemists and life elixir together in the same sentence. Also, it mentions heals diseases and grants long life when ingested. That sounds like Marvin is using magic to grant Jack a long life, and that is the same with the Philosopher's Stone, because it mentions creating an elixir that would make humans younger, delaying death. So does that mean Marvin is learning philosophy in order to keep negative energy out and learning magic to create an elixir? Sorry if my research was a little choppy, because I was editing this video at 12 a.m, and I was a little nervous of today thinking that Jack is gonna do anything sus. Speaking of, if there's gonna be something happening on the 31st, there will probably be a mini theory video on it. So I think that's the best time to end this theory video here, but if there's any news, I'll definitely do a mini theory video on it. So this was a pretty long one, because of the old topics that I haven't gotten to talk about, but it was worth saving it for Halloween. And yes, I know I uploaded this video just a day before Halloween, but I wanted to do something for this month, because of motivation and all. So I hope you all are staying safe, social distancing, wearing a mask, and most importantly, being quarantined. So, I'll see you all fellow theorists later, and keep theorizing, and happy early Halloween.